Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on Pulse and Digital Circuit subject. So we are discussing chapter 1. The name of the chapter is Linear Wave Shaping. Today in this chapter we will see the response of RC low pass circuit with step input. So we will derive what is the response of this circuit for the step input. Now, as you know that the RC low pass circuit consisting of only two elements, resistor and capacitor. So remember that we take the voltage across capacitor in low pass circuit. See, this is the VI of t, that is the input voltage applied to the circuit. The current flowing through this loop is say I of t, and the output voltage across the capacitor is say V0 of t. So this is the circuit with input and output. So the voltage across resistor is say VR, the voltage across capacitor is say VC. Now for this circuit, what we are applying? So we are applying a step input. As you know that the step input VI of t versus t. So what is step input? Step input is a constant voltage which we apply. Let us assume that this voltage is V. The constant voltage is applied to the circuit. So as you know that I explained earlier, so applying KVL to this loop, at any instant of time the input voltage is equal to VR plus VC, because the circuit consisting of linear elements, the input voltage VI of t at any instant of time is equal to VR plus VC. So therefore, first point you have to write is that at any instant of time in the circuit consisting of linear elements and passive elements, so VI of t is equal to VR plus VC. So that means if the capacitor voltage increases, resistor voltage decreases, and vice versa, such that the sum of these two voltages is always equal to input voltage. So that is the property with which the circuit works. Now the second point you have to remember is that the capacitor, very very important point, capacitor always charges and discharges exponentially. So this is a very 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 important point of this chapter. So the capacitor always charges exponentially and discharges exponentially. So the basic operation is that when you give a voltage to the circuit, when you give a constant voltage to the circuit, what will happen? Initially the voltage across the capacitor is zero. The capacitor, by the property of the capacitor starts charging exponentially towards the applied voltage capital V. So that is the simple operation of the circuit. So we will derive what is the expression for V0 of t and what is the waveform of V0 of t. Now, so applying KVL to the circuit, applying Kirchhoff voltage law to the loop. So as you know that VI of t is written as VI of t. So VI of t is written as I of t into R plus what is the voltage across capacitor, 1 by C into integration of I of t dt. So what is the input voltage now? The input voltage is a constant voltage, so that is V. So that is equal to I of t into R plus 1 by C into integration of I of t dt. Now differentiate this equation, differentiate with respect to t. So this equation differentiate with respect to t. Now rearrange the terms. So therefore, the first term I am writing it as R into di by dt. So R into di by dt is differentiation integration gets cancels out, 1 by C into I. So that is constant voltage differentiation is 0. So furthermore, if you divide it by R, this equation, so di by dt plus 1 by RC into I, so that is equal to 0. So this is the first order differential equation. Remember that this is the first order differential equation which can be very easily solved for this current with respect to time. So now let d by dt is equal to capital T, let us say. So this equation is written as d plus 1 by RC into I is equal to 0. So d plus 1 by RC into I is equal to 0. So from which the roots of this equation are obtained by equating d plus 1 by RC is equal to 0. So therefore the roots are what is d plus 1 by RC is equal to 0. That means d will become minus 1 by RC. Let us call this root as m1. As you know that when the root is m1, the solution is c1 into e power m1t. So therefore the solution of this first order differential equation is the solution of above differential equation is, so we are deriving the expression for I of t. So I of t is equal to c1, some constant e power m1, m1 is minus 1 by RC, that will become minus t by RC. So this is the current expression in this loop. Let us find out the constant c1 from the circuit initial conditions. So let us derive this. So at t is equal to 0, let us interpret the circuit. At t is equal to 0, let us draw the circuit. So at t is equal to 0, the resistor will remain same. So since the voltage across capacity is 0, so therefore capacitor acts as short circuit. The capacitor voltage is 0. At t is equal to 0, what is the input voltage? Step input voltage V. So therefore, what is the current I of 0 at t is equal to 0? That means at t is equal to 0, the input voltage is V. What is the current flowing through this loop? V by R. So therefore, at t is equal to 0, the current I of 0 flowing through the loop is V by R. We use this initial condition to solve C1. So therefore, at t is equal to 0 in this equation, what is I of 0? Current flowing through the loop is V by R. So that is equal to C1, e power 0 is 1. So this is the value of C1. Now substitute C1 in this equation. The current in the loop is given by V by R into e power minus T by RC, which decreases exponentially with respect to time. So this is the current equation in the loop. No. So therefore, what is coming to the circuit, we have found, so what is the expression for I of t? So therefore, what is the voltage across resistor? I of t into R. So therefore, let us write the voltage across resistor. So VR is equal to simple formula from the circuit, I of t into R. So I of t we got is V by R into e power minus t by RC into R. So therefore, R gets cancels out. So therefore, the voltage across resistor is equal to V into e power minus T by RC. So as I explained earlier, at any instant of time, the input voltage VA of T is equal to what is the relation? VR plus VC. From this, what is the input voltage? V, that is a step voltage. So VR we got is V into e power minus T by RC plus the voltage across capacity is nothing but as output voltage. So therefore from this, take this term to this side. So therefore VC, that is voltage across capacitor, is equal to V into, bring this term this side, we take V as common, e power minus T by RC. So this is the expression for output voltage. So which is also called, since the output voltage across capacitor is nothing but as our output voltage, which is represented as V0 of t. So this is the expression we have to derive. So this is an exponentially increasing equation. In mathematics, this equation is an exponentially increasing equation from mathematics knowledge. Increasing equation. That is, the voltage across capacitor increases exponentially. Let us plot this graph. At t is equal to 0. So what is the voltage or output voltage across capacitor? Let us see. At t is equal to 0 in this equation. So e power 0 is 1. 1 minus 1, 0. The output voltage is 0. So at t is equal to infinity, let us say, so the, what is the output voltage? Let us see. If you substitute t minus infinity, e power minus infinity is 0, 1 minus 0, 0, 1 minus 0, 1. So that is equal to V. So that means, so this, from these conditions, we can draw the output graph as, say, this is the output graph, which is nothing but the voltage across capacitor. So this is t, so this is z, time axis. So therefore, what is the final voltage? So let us call this as a step input. This is the given step input. So what is the graph? The capacitor at t is equal to 0, the voltage is 0, at t is equal to infinity, it finally charges to exponentially to a voltage of V at t is equal to infinity with the equation of V into 1 minus e power minus t by RC. So this is the graph we have to plot. The voltage across capacitor increases exponentially towards V. Now finally, let us see with the different time constants, with the different time constants, different time constants, let us see what will be the graph. Say, for example, I'm drawing it again with the different time constants. Say this is voltage across capacitor, this is time, this is the step input voltage of voltage V. If the time constant is very small, so that means the capacitor charges very quickly towards 5 volts. That means the time constant RC is small. The capacitor quickly charges to the applied voltage. For example, if the capacitor, if the time constant is medium, it will charge exponentially something like this. If the time constant is, if RC is medium. For example, if time constant is large, it takes a large amount of time to reach to V. So therefore, RC is large. So this is the response of the circuit with the different time constants. Finally, we derive the expression for rise time, and we will conclude this article. Rise time. So therefore, we define the rise time. Let us define first. This is the time taken by the capacitor voltage to increase from 10% to 90% of its final voltage is called rise time. So very, very important definition, rise time. So that means it is the time taken by this capacitor voltage, to rise from 10%. 10% means 0.1V, because the final voltage is V. Let us call this time as T1, to 90%. 90% of V, 0.9. So this is 0.9V. Let us call this time as T2. So it is the time taken by the capacitor voltage to increase from 10% to 90% is called as rise time, which is called represented with TR. So let us find out this expression for TR now. So therefore, what is the voltage across capacitor? The voltage across capacitor, output voltage, is given by the expression V into 1 minus e power minus T by RC. So for example, if 10% voltage means 0.1V, so that is equal to V. That means at T is equal to T1, we write like this, at T is equal to T1, what is the voltage? Output voltage, 0.1V from the graph, so that is equal to 1 minus e power minus T1 by RC. So cancel out V and V, and it bring this term this side, 1 minus 0.1 will become 0.9, therefore e power minus T1 by RC is equal to 0.9. Take natural logarithm on both sides, take natural logarithm on both sides. So therefore, we get t1 is equal to log 0.9 minus minus 10 gets cancels out. You will get 0.105 RC. So this is the first expression. T1. Similarly, let us find out T2 from the diagram. At T2, at time t is equal to T2, so what is the output voltage? It reaches to 0.9 V, so that is equal to V into 1 minus e power minus T2 by RC. Just cancel out V and V. So cancel out V and V. So bring this term this side, and 1 minus 0.9 will become 0.1. Therefore, e power minus T2 by RC, so that is equal to 0.1. If you take logarithm on both sides, we get finally T2 is equal to 2.303 RC. So this is the T2 expression. Now, finally, what is the rise time? The rise time TR is equal to T2 minus T1. That is the time taken for the capacitor to charge from 10% to 90%. Substitute T2, this one, and T1, this one, and finally we get rise time as approximately equal to 2.2 RC, where RC is the time constant of the circuit. Finally, we derive, we modify this equation into one more format. Let F2 is equal to upper 3 dB frequency, we will derive later, upper 3 dB frequency, let us call this as upper 3 dB frequency of RC low pass circuit. Let us, this formula is 1 by 2 pi RC, same formula as lower 3 dB frequency. Remember that both formulas are same for lower 3 dB frequency and upper 3 dB frequency. The formulas are same. The upper 3 dB frequency is F2 is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. Let us convert this equation in terms of F2. So therefore, the rise time is given by, from this equation, what will be the RC? So RC is equal to, bring this side, it will become 1 by 2 pi F2. Substitute RC is equal to 1 by 2 pi F2 in this equation. So therefore, it is approximately equal to 2.2 into RC is 1 by 2 pi F2. So 2.2 divided by 2 pi F2 will become, so rise time, so is equal to 0.35 approximately by F2. F2 is the cutoff frequency of the filter. So this is another very, very important formula we use while solving the problems, the relation between rise time and upper 3 dB frequency. So this is all about this. This is all about this response of RC low pass circuit with step input. So this is the very, very important question in the examination. Thank you.